and you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Hello and welcome to Business Line with me, Pranab Bakshi. Over the next half hour, we'll be looking at all the business news from around the country. First up, India's mobile phone density is around 40%, but by 2014, telecom experts are predicting this figure to double. One of the reasons why we see a lot of new entrants in this market. Tata Docomo is one. Here's the next one.
The latest mobile service brand is in town, Uninor. It's the GSM service of Unitech Wireless, a joint venture between real estate major Unitech and Norway-based mobile service provider Telenor. Unitech Wireless, with its pan-India license, will be operating in all of India's 22 circles.
Ini yen number.
It plans to achieve an 8% market share over the next 5 years by outsourcing a large part of its services.
Our business model is outsourcing the things that we are not good at doing ourselves. Meaning all infrastructure, network, IT, we have been outsourced to vendors, to partners that take care of all that. And then we jointly together are developing exactly the system that we want to show our customers.
Uninor is going in for a different pricing model compared to the 1 paise per second billing that most telcos are offering today. Uninor's tariffs start from 29 paise.
We are talking about two price models. One is call more, meaning that if you are using your telephone more than 100, four times a day, then you will be able to have a better product at the per second paise billing. And the other product is talk more, means that if you use your telephone for each call more than 100 seconds, then this product will be the best in the market.
As of now, Uninor has gone live in 7 circles, including East and West Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. By Q2 next year, the nationwide rollout will be complete.
State-owned BSNL's plan to storm the Middle East and the African markets seems to be in cold freeze. BSNL has put on hold its move to acquire a large stake in Kuwait-based Zain Telecom. Arijit Banerjee has this report.
BSNL's chairman Kuldeep Goyal has been scouting for new markets to grow his company, which has been sitting on a large pile of cash. But his latest foray to team up with little-known Vavasi consortium to buy around 46% stake in Zain Telecom seems to be stuck. BSNL has decided to put on hold its plans to go ahead with the deal, valued at a little over $13 billion.
We asked certain information from the company from whom the proposal was received, that is Vavasi. We have not yet received any information, so there is no further progress on that.
Sources tell NDTV that BSNL's move is also driven by government concern over Vavasi's ability to carry forward this deal. BSNL is also having a rethink, because the ongoing tariff war means that the company, which actually saw its profit drop 80% last year, may have to draw on its cash reserves to meet its capex requirements this year.
Expansions are going on now. Already whatever expansions were planned for mobile, already 30 million expansion is already going on in various areas. So there is a huge program going on.
BSNL, however, will continue to look abroad as the Indian market gets saturated. And once the exclusivity talks between Vavasi and Zain are over, it may decide to partner with MTNL, another government-owned telco, to try and stitch a deal with Zain on its own. In New Delhi, with Debdatta Das, Orijit Banerjee for NDTV Profit.
So what is India's king of retail planning in his expansion? Does he plan to go solo or is he looking for global alliances? And how will he raise funds for his expansion? Let's meet Kishore Biyani and hear from him.
The capex, we heard 360 crores. I mean, what will it be aimed at? Is that the right thing?
But that's the current expansion plans for Pantaloons Retail to add up 2.4 million square feet of retail space in the Pantaloons Retail balance sheet, not the subsidiaries.
So how many
I think that's for the next balance 7-8 months.
Just to take off from what you just mentioned, you're talking about an IPO of Big Bazaar.
We are looking at subsidiarization of Big Bazaar into a separate company. And if the ambition of Big Bazaar is big enough and if they need capital, probably they can raise capital.
That's interesting, sir. But what kind of 1,200 crores is what you've talked about historically?
I think it depends on the appetite. We believe Big Bazaar is a pan-India model. It can grow quite a lot and it can serve the nation in terms of democratizing shopping. And if the ambitions are big, we believe we are in a position to grow bigger. And if you want to grow big, that's the reason why we are subsidizing it, and probably it can raise its own capital.
Telecom companies are now in an all-out war, and this is putting immense pressure on their bottom lines. But not all telecom companies are unhappy. In fact, this war is proving out to be a boom for new entrants, giving them a chance to gain customers and also close in on the established players.
Telecom companies are in a do-or-die price war, and it's dividing them in more ways than one. While all players fight it out to survive in this increasingly competitive market, it's the new entrants who are on the offensive. Tata Docomo, Aircel and Uninor all believe this price war will give them an opportunity to catch up in volume terms with the more established players. Tata is even claiming that their per-second pulse scheme has netted them the highest number of subscribers over the past few months. However, it is the older, more established telcos that are feeling the pinch of ever-thinning margins.
I said that yes, I think it's going to be a record of sorts, that our revenues and our earnings out of this will make us a bit of positive in the southern circles in the shortest possible time anybody would have ever achieved.
It is this worry over the future of the telecom sector that is prompting the regulator to look at the need for intervention.
There is going to be some hit on the revenue, of course, once the tariffs are that low. But we hope that with the volume increase in traffic and all, it should get compensated.
Telecom regulator TRAI is evaluating whether it should continue allowing operators to decide on tariffs or should it take over those powers.
Even as TRAI puts its head together to work out a solution, for the time being it's a free-for-all which may only increase in intensity as mobile number portability rings in next year. And while telecom operators may cry for all they want, it's never been better for mobile users. In New Delhi, with Orijit Banerjee, Deepdatta Das, NDTV Profit.
And now a quick look at the markets.
The BSE opened this week at 16,897 points, went up to a 17,351, only to close at 17,101, about 204 points up. The Nifty 2 followed the same trend, only to close at 5,108 points. India's GDP growth number for the July to September quarter came to a robust 7.9%, much higher than most expectations. Growth in manufacturing and community, social services, indicative of government spending, drove the numbers. The week saw both stock exchanges, NSE and BSE, flag off new platforms in which investors will be able to buy and sell mutual fund units, much like stocks. The long-drawn takeover battle for Great Offshore, a drilling rig provider, came to an end, with ABG Shipyard withdrawing from the race and Bharti Shipyard raising its open offer price. IPO season appears to be picking up again, with three offers set to debut over the next 2 weeks. Godrej Properties, DB Corp, publishers of Dainik Bhaskar newspaper, and JSW Energy.
Stay tuned to Businessline. We'll be right back with Rajiv in conversation with Aarti Krishnan, Research Head, Businessline.